welcome back to a brand new video. Simon down here at Burford Golf Lab. Thank you to Rob, one of our members. I'll get it to focus on the grip so you can see it. Hey, there we go. I have no idea how to pronounce that. I'm gonna go with Barocci. I completely butchered that name. Anyway, Rob, thank you. Not only have you helped for the top bottom end of my driver, but now the top end. And basically, this is a swing-weighted grip. It's got a 17-gram tungsten weight in the top of the driver. So more of the weight feels this end. So it feels lighter this end. So the weight of the driver itself, it probably gone up like a couple of grams if you put this on scales, for example. However, it feels lighter in the head, which potentially means that I might be able to feel like I can swing my hands faster, and obviously if my hand speed increases, club head speed will increase as well. To be perfectly honest, when it comes to weighted grips, because Jack Nicklaus used weighted grips a lot throughout his career, it's to give you more control, to feel like it's more in the hands rather than in the bottom head of the club. Obviously with bigger heads nowadays, especially like cast iron heads, beginner heads, oversized heads, a lot of the weight feels down at the bottom. If you're one of these people that wants a natural feeling, a lighter club, having this at the top end is potentially going to help you, because obviously a lot more weight, just moving a gram up this way, is gonna change the swing weight on the club. So even from a tour velvet to a multi-compound, you're gonna change the swing weight of your club. That is what I learned from my PGA degree. So I'm gonna hit this. I'm gonna hopefully hit some decent drives with it, potentially a new PB. I'm taking it day by day. If you're new to the channel, welcome. My name's Simon. I wanna do long drive next year. Please subscribe, follow the journey. And at the moment it's slow progress, but I feel like I'm getting faster and stronger. But the progress in terms of ball speed and distance is a slow one, a slow journey, as long as Lord of the Rings from start to finish. The best 2009 practice session for my long drive to date. Warm up felt very good, even though I did legs and hit them pretty hard with squats and deadlifts the day before, and that normally ruins my practice session for the next day in terms of numbers. I actually felt pretty good, and quite quickly I realized this. You see, I've just got my normal work shoes, a pretty crappy glove, and I actually go and change everything because I wanted to go after it. I felt like I could hit some PBs today after putting this new grip on. Now, is it a coincidence that I hit a PB with this? Probably not. I actually like the feeling of it. My driver is very heavy. The chances of me building the perfect driver for myself is one in a million, seeing as I've taken a shaft out of Root Golf Head. Rob's given me the Crank Golf 4 Degree. I've also got this grip that he's given me. So the chances that I've built the world's first Frankenstein long drive driver that's perfectly suited to me is quite unlikely. However, if you gave this driver to world number one long driver, he's gonna hit it 420, 430. So at the end of the day, numbers are numbers, and there's only so much equipment can do for you. However, by putting this grip in the driver and making a lot more weight towards my hands, I felt a lot more comfortable. And when you can keep consistently finding the middle of the face when you're hitting these lengths of driver, it makes your life a lot easier, because all you're normally worried about is like, don't roof it, don't sky it, don't thin it. Whereas this was basically a session of, let's see how fast I can ramp it up. So I start getting faster and faster. And as I said, I changed my shoes and my gloves. And I felt really good throughout this session. And you saw the thumbnail, I hit a PB, and we'll talk about that swing in a minute, because actually it was towards the later my round where the energy wasn't as high, but my technique was a lot better. And each session that I have, my technique gets better and better. You can see me almost jumping a lot more throughout my sets now, trying to generate as much force throughout the ground as I possibly can, and then jumping up just before impact to then get the launch, get that ball up in the air. And I'm looking at my swing, and it, to be perfectly honest, from the stuff that Lee Cox went through with me, there's so many technical things I'm still not doing, but we're still increasing ball speed. And I was getting close to the 190 average mark, 188, 190, 191. And they started getting faster and faster, and I kept finding the middle more and more. And that could be down to the grip. I like the feeling. There's no, this could be just a day everything aligned. But my personal thoughts is, the grip is cool. And if you want a lighter feeling club, if you feel like your driver's too heavy or your irons are too heavy, this could be a way of lightening everything up, getting more weight in your hands and not necessarily getting a really thick grip. Because again, that does take a lot of the weight and feeling out of a head. So I hit some good ones. This is with my shoes, my normal shoes and glove for extra grip and support. And I was in a good set. I was definitely in the zone. So
191 there. Again, that's my normal personal best, I would say. I have had 192 before, but I didn't catch it on camera, and I've been trying for ages to try and beat a PB on camera, but every time I've come to it, I've either hit longer distances. I mean, my 381 drive is with a 186 ball speed, which is quite low, but the numbers were perfect. So if I got a 192 with the perfect numbers, we're gonna get 400 yard drives. I just haven't achieved it yet. So this is the swing. I felt pretty tired at this point. However, technique was really good. Got straight through it. I basically hit through the golf ball. Launch was too low. Spin, unfortunately, wasn't high enough. I wasn't even paying attention. I knew I hit it out in the middle, but when I finally looked at the screen later and I saw that 194 ball speed, I was so ecstatic, especially out of it on camera, and just progress. The great thing about doing these YouTube videos is that I get to look at progress. I get to look back at January when I was ecstatic with 180, and when I started, I was at 170. So we're getting there. It's slowly going up. And as I say, if I hit that with the perfect launch, at like a 14 degree launch with 1-4 ball speed, that's going 400 yards. And that means that it's getting competitive. There's no way that I'm winning circle yet. A nice slow-mo here. However, we're definitely getting there. And I feel by next year, we're definitely going to have a chance. We're definitely going to be threatening or competing at least. And there's going to be other elements like wind direction, the grid, competition, pressure, adrenaline. That'd be interesting. I'd love to know the ball speeds to start producing with adrenaline as well. That's going to be something I'm going to have to cope with. But overall, happy with the new grip on my golf club. As I say, it's something you guys can have a look at. I didn't hit, unfortunately, any PBs. I didn't get past the 381 mark, but it's not going to be long. It's basically more down to time and me just getting lucky, basically. All my technique getting better. I think that's probably more important. Anyways, guys, thank you ever so much for the support. I'm going to wind down, give you my thoughts now. But yeah, really happy.
Okay, I didn't get the perfect drive at that session. But the improvement, 194, first of all, is a new ball speed record, and it went straight, so it's not like a duck hook left, club face massively closed. And especially when I changed my shoes, gloves, I knew I felt good, I knew I had it in me, I knew I could go after it and get through it. And when you're consistently hitting it out the middle, especially when the tee's that long, and you can literally give it everything and not be concerned about missing the golf ball, that's when I knew that obviously pushing it today would be good. Unfortunately, I don't know what my max was. I think, yeah, 371 was my max. But the ball speed's getting there. Getting to 200 miles an hour is definitely getting there. I think definitely by Christmas, I mean, that set consistently was 190. With quite a few of the drives, I was just launching them way too low, so then they just didn't have a chance of getting all the way out there to 380. But 190 ball speed on the right angles and launch, and 190 plus is 400 yards. So, still got to work on the technique, still got to work on obviously getting bigger and faster, but the fact I've posted 194, considering back in January, I was at like 175, 180 was like my personal best. We go up to 193 and I feel like using the ground more than anything, pushing off at the start, gearing towards it, and then really jumping up at impact again, just basically lassoes that club around you. And when you catch it, you know it's gone. But fortunately, didn't hit personal best in terms of distance. We will get to the back of this grid, I guarantee you. The grip, in terms of this, I felt good, felt better than I normally have done, to be perfectly honest. But having this more in the hands, feeling more weight in my hands, I think that contributed. As I say, pleased with the results, pleased with how hard and fast we were hitting the ball. Guys, thank you ever so much for watching. As always, leave this video a like if you liked it. Subscribe if you're new. Catch you guys later.